Vision Sunday. Part 6. The Ark of the Covenant. Acknowledgement. This represents my takeaway from the sermon of January 2, 2022 by Pastor Joseph Prince of New Creation Church. All scriptures are quoted from the Amplified Bible unless otherwise stated. The Ark of the Covenant. The Ark of the Covenant was originally housed in the Tabernacle of Moses, also called the Tabernacle of the Congregation. David brought the Ark to Jerusalem and placed it in a tent, the Tabernacle of David. The Ark stayed in David's tabernacle for 40 years until it was moved into the temple built and dedicated by David's son Solomon. Every aspect of the Ark of Covenant points to Jesus the Christ. First up, it is made of the incorruptible acacia wood, oblong or rectangular in shape. The wood is not visible because it is overlaid with gold.
Sure, the shape speaks of a coffin, a tomb. It alludes to Jesus' death at burial.
Good observation, my child.
He knew no sin. He did no sin. In him was no sin. Gold speaks of the divinity of Jesus. Jesus was fully God and yet fully man, God in human form. Jesus being the brightness of God's glory, as stated in Hebrews 1:3, is the gold of the Ark of the Covenant. Jesus became the express image of the person of God so that we can see what God is like.
Those who have seen Jesus has seen the Father. Today, we see Jesus in the Bible.
Yes indeed, my boy.
The row of crown lining the lid of the mercy seat points to Jesus upholding all things by the word of his power. The mercy seat is the gold lid placed on the Ark of the Covenant. When the blood drops on the mercy seat, it depicts the forgiveness of sins. When the blood is on the mercy seat, the Ark of the Covenant becomes functional. Forgiveness of sins flows out. Jesus by himself purged our sins, refers to his perfect finished work with his blood, that he shed at the cross. Before that, the Ark of the Covenant was not functioning the way God intended for it to function. For example, without the blood on the mercy seat, bringing the Ark of the Covenant to a war would not result in victory in the Old Testament.
You got no Ark, he no scared.
In the case of Israel, the high priest would enter the Holy of Holies to sprinkle the blood on the mercy seat once a year. When forgiveness of sins flows out through the blood of Jesus, people receive healing, breakthroughs and blessings of every kind.
Your sins are forgiven. Be hallowed.
Even death, the last enemy, is conquered by the blood of Jesus.
I no fight against Jesus' powerla.
It brings to mind Genesis 3:15 when God first promised to send a Savior. And I will put enmity between thee and the woman, and between thy seed and her seed, it shall bruise thy head, and thou shalt bruise his heel. God is faithful. What he said, he would do. What he promised, he would fulfill. It is recorded in Romans 3:25 of the American Standard Version that God set forth Jesus as the propitiation, hilasterion in Greek, or mercy seat.
Sure, I did some research. The word hilasterion is found twice in the New Testament, Romans 11:25 and Hebrews 9:5. In the Romans passage, the context is the sacrificial death of Christ. Whereas in the Hebrew passage, the context is a description of the Holy of Holies and its contents. The Epistle to the Hebrews portrays the role of the mercy seat during Yom Kippur Day of Atonement as a prefiguration of the Passion of Christ, which was a greater atonement, and the formation of a new covenant. The Yom Kippur ritual was a shadow of things to come. The continual sacrifice for sin under the Mosaic Covenant became obsolete following the once-for-all sacrificial death of Christ.
Keep up the good work, my beloved child.
So, God set Jesus as the mercy seat where the blood is sprinkled. What does the mercy seat cover? There are three items inside the Ark of the Covenant. Each item depicts the sins of the people of Israel vis-a-vis our sins.
Sure, just thinking aloud. Father God works on the principle of representation. He has chosen the people of Israel as representatives of humanity in general. All of us would have behaved exactly like them under the same circumstances. In the Old Testament, it is death to look inside the Ark of the Covenant. The fact that we can now look inside it and not die shows that death has been conquered.
You are not far from the truth, my beloved child.
Beneath the mercy seat are the golden pot of manna, Aaron's rod, the two tablets of stone, the Ten Commandments. The golden pot of manna. Israel murmured against the Lord when God gave them manna for food, saying, "What is it?" Manna literally means that, "What is it?" They despised the manna, God's provision. The manna alluded to Jesus as the bread of life who came down from heaven. Aaron's rod. Again, the people murmured against Aaron the high priest. They despised God's authority and rebelled. God caused the rod, a dead tree so to speak, to sprout in order to silence the murmuring. It speaks of life from the dead and therein alluded to the resurrection of Jesus. The two stone tablets. The Ten Commandments engraved in letters on two tablets of stone, represented the rejection of God's standards or His holiness. In a nutshell, the three items depicted the rebellion and disobedience of humanity. But God put all our sins under the mercy seat. Curiosity kills the cat. When the Philistines sent the Ark of the Covenant back to Israel, the people of Beth Shemesh were curious. They pushed aside the mercy seat to look inside the Ark and were struck dead.
Why?
It is because the law, which makes people conscious of sins, leads to death. It is Jesus, the mercy seat, who gives life. In a nutshell, the people of Israel rejected God's provision. Law demands. Grace supplies. It is stated in Galatians 5:4 that Christ is of no effect when a person tries to be justified by the law. That person has fallen from grace.
Ayo, jato. Hukay.
Grace is higher than the law. But many believers are bringing the law out from under the mercy seat like the people of Beth Shemesh. The letter of the law kills by revealing sin and demanding obedience, but the Spirit gives life. God wants to forgive our sins by the blood of Jesus. For this reason, He instructed the three items to be put under the mercy seat in the Old Testament.
On the third day of Jesus' death, the first day of the week, the stone, law, was rolled away from the tomb because Jesus was resurrected, giving life.
Jesus isn't here. He is risen from the dead.
The resurrected life of Jesus has swallowed up death.
But so long as the stone, life, is not rolled away, there is death.
Only Jesus could keep the law perfectly.
See, love is in me, he art.
And Jesus is the substance of the Ark of the Covenant. Jesus has taken away all of my sins in him. Summary. In summary, the Ark of the Covenant speaks of the person of Jesus. The gold and the wood depicts Jesus as fully God and fully man. The mercy seat speaks of his perfect finished work. In Christ and him crucified, we find rest.